The panel name is Gender Equality Plans and Policies. And in fact, I will start with, in the backdrop, the United Nations SDG number 5, which is Sustainable Development Goal, which says to achieve gender equality and empowering all women and girls. So very good. I will also quote the another, which is GRC, the Global Research Council's statement and plan, principles and plan, which talks about equality and status of women researchers. So I think very important topic today, and I'm privileged to come here and to attend this. And CEFIPRA has been, by now you know what is CEFIPRA, and in fact CEFIPRA is one of the co-organizers for this meeting. Now, I will have two slides. First, showing you the important two ladies. Right. One from France and one from India. So Madam Emilie Chatlett, she was a philosopher, a mathematician, a physicist, author. You know, some of her theories in physics are still considered as a standard. In fact, that lady lived only 43 years, but she has made a lot of difference, and she died because of the childbirth that time, and child also died after 20 months. But she has made a lot of contribution for science. Similarly, I have another picture here, Anandi Gopal Joshi. And she lived only 22, 23 years. And this lady was the first female doctor from India. And in fact, what happened, she gave birth to a boy when she was 14 years old. And the child, the boy, died after 10 days because of lack of medical facilities that time. So we are talking about 1865 when she was born. And now, why I am showing you this picture, because this was the source of inspiration. That was the turning point in her life, and she decided that let me do something and let me study medicine. And the first I said, the turning point, and second one is the encouragement given to her by her husband. And husband allowed her to go to USA and did her medicine. So she was the first female doctor, acquired degree in medicine, and that too from USA. And so one was the turning point in her life, and second, the encouragement from the husband. Now, if you look at the scenario, the Indian scenario and French scenario, here, you know, quite similarity. Of course, in the third bullet, when Gopal Joshi, Anandi Gopal Joshi, was studying medicine that time, less than 1%, that is 0.2% in 1881, the female literacy rate was in India. And later on, it increased to 1.8 in 1921, and now it is approximately 66%, which is 99% here in France, and which is ranked as 37 out of 215 countries. So if you look at the last bullet here, the Anandi Gopal Joshi became India's first female doctor in 1885, and here, Dorothea Klumke became the first woman to be awarded a doctorate degree in science in France. That was in 1893. So I'm just trying to tell you the situation has gone, you know, has improved a lot, but still a lot need to be done. Now, these are some of the ladies on top. So I have taken two examples, like two ladies from France, the first one there, and here, two ladies from India. And I was really fortunate to meet all of them. Have been meeting several times, but I met all of them in 2018. So what influenced them for making choices or choice for science? Madam Vidal, in fact, we were thinking that she will be here, but she couldn't come because of some urgency there. You know, a biochemist from University of Nice, an academician, an administrator, a politician, now the minister. Madam Catherine Brackignack, perpetual secretary, has been the president of CNRS, a physicist, and has reached to that level. Madam Soumya Swaminathan was the secretary of the Department of Health Research in the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. And now, in December last year, in 2017, she has become the deputy director general of WHO, which is the highest position achieved by any Indian in WHO. So she is a medical doctor and was a policymaker in government of India and left the job and became that, and now she is serving the whole world. Similarly, Dr. Renu Sarup. In fact, we tried to bring both of them here, and I met personally both of them and requested them if they can also come and sensitize and tell their stories here. But they all were preoccupied during these days, so they couldn't come. But I would like to tell you about them. So what influenced them? Family, friends, media, innovation in science and technology, career professionals, professional institutes, governmental policies, everything. So they reached to the highest level. Now, I won't say weaknesses. These are some of the limitations. I've been with the funding agencies throughout my life, and now with the CEFIPRA, but what I have realized here, the women, the girls, the ladies have very good tendency to cooperate. And they are willing to take any responsibility given any time. Multiple roles they are playing at home, at offices, and they are keen to learn new skills, new things. This is the positive side of the woman. They are open to new proposals, supportive to others, and care for an equal distribution of learning tasks. No doubt, these are all very, very positive, I would say, strength, and we must utilize these strengths, whether it is in India or in France or anywhere in the world. But there are certain limitations. Whether limitations or barriers, one of the PhD student yesterday talked about, I think Akhila is her name. Yeah. I would definitely agree with her that there is a need to improve the environment at home, in the society, in the place of work, where the environment-guided decision-making is limited and is affecting their career. Yes, there are certain role models, but there is a limitation of role models, lack of publicity aimed at women, because somebody talked about yesterday, we must create some kind of awareness, some kind of festival, some kind of documentary which can be shown on the TV or somewhere. So we need to, you know, sensitize more and more girls and ladies to take science as a career, and they can excel, no doubt about it, because they have a lot of strength within them. Limited job opportunity, sometimes underestimation, that is also there. Oh, you can't do that. But yes, they can do anything. Insufficient encouragement and family support, which is always there, which is, you know, on a higher side, little bit, in some part of India, not in the urban areas, but definitely it affects. Flexible working hours. Somebody talked about the flexibility has to be there. Yes, of course. Because they have to manage home as well as their lab, their workplace, everything. So that kind of flexibility is required. And also somebody talked about the soft feminism, and I was attending a meeting and that soft communication sometimes, because that also, it doesn't mean that it is a negative aspect of it, but definitely it affects their career sometimes. Now, why do we need more women in science? We should not waste talent. Somebody talked, I think Suchetna talked about diversity. So having more diversified workforce, they offer diversity several times. Create better work environment and more candidate attitude. Of course, nobody can deny this fact. So why do we waste the talent? Role. Somebody also talked about the government has to play a role. And in fact, we need to create conditions and supportive environment for them. It is not like we are doing some favor. It is not like that. But it is definitely developing leadership, business skills of women. We need to create some dedicated funding for research programs. We need to support networks and mentorship scheme if somebody needs that. Moral support, aiming to eliminate gender-wise gender barriers and encourage gender-sensitive approach in research. Yes, definitely. And government is doing a lot. And there are several programs which were shown by Vandana Singh of DST like this. So you have gone through this slide by Vandana Singh and as well as by Dr. Nina Valecha. So I, as I said, that I was also having some examples of these programs like Kiran, Curie. So some of the Indian funding agencies have come out with various programs for women in science, or for women applicants, INSPIRE, WEDPs, BOSP, BOSC, DST Task Force, a special program for ladies, DBT. And this program was created by one of the picture I was showing you, Dr. Renu Sarup, BioCare. That was for woman scientist, and there are many more by DHR, ICMR, DRDO, but again, I would say lots need to be done. Yeah. Now, these are some important slides, right? So give me 2 minutes extra. Women can do easily what men are supposed to do. If some lady will say like this, that you may not, but I'm speaking from my heart. I'm a father of 2 daughters. But I always tell them that you can do easily what men are supposed to do. So ladies, you don't have to be superwoman all the time. Congratulate yourself because you have passion, you have courage, you have talent. You don't need any arm and ammunition to prove yourself. So this is what I always tell and trying to say here. Now, because I need to show some data, existing data and practices followed by the CEFIPRA. Now, I was telling you about the programs of last 10 years yesterday, but here, since inception of 30 years, these are the numbers here. If you look at my program with academic collaboration right from the beginning, there were 1,109 Indian and French PIs, and out of which 187, approximately 17%, were women PIs and co-PIs. So I'm talking about right from 1987. My industry academy program, again, it is approximately, I have done the calculations here for, this is 25%, and my other programs, it is 33% for number 3, and then 14%, 15%, something like that. Now, if you look at the regulatory and advisory body of CEFIPRA, there have been 14 co-chairs, and out of these 14 co-chairs, 4 were women. And, you know, 31 meetings have been organized, and out of these 31 meetings, 12 were chaired by lady co-chairperson. 40% of women from India and France are represented by scientific council, and, you know, some of them are here. One is here today chairing this session here, Tanusri Dasgupta, and others are sitting there. 17% were women from India and France represented my IRC committee. As I said yesterday, out of 5, there was only 1 woman scientist who directed the center. Now, I am happy to share this picture. Some of the Indian women scientists, or PIs, who were CEFIPRA PIs, and one of them is here. Dr. Maitri Dasgupta, the projects were graded excellent. Similarly, I have a picture for French woman scientist, and one of them is present here, Dr. Angela. So these were some of the, you know, success stories by women scientists through CEFIPRA supported projects. These are again numbers. Total numbers of 30 years. So far, 15% women scientists have been from India and France, 85%. So look at that. The number is increasing now, but look at the 1987 when the CEFIPRA was created, but still, on an average, there were 542 projects have been supported, and out of this, 15% women scientists and 85% men. And out of this is the, again, here, my targeted program, 24% are still the PIs and co-PIs. These are the programs which are very new program of the last 5 years. So you can see the number of the 30 years is 15%. Here, the number of the program of last 5 years is 24%. Now, again, these are last three years, 36%, 46%. Yes, SOLI synchrotone is little bit less because there were less applicant this time. This is very important slide. Is science still a boys' club? The answer is no. Because it is only a perception. We need to do away with this kind of thinking. We need to change our mindset about it. So it is not a boys' club, only. Now my last slide here, increase, what can be the possible scope for improvement? Increase women's participation in research workforce at decision-making level. Somebody said that there is very less number of women scientists heading an institute, and Dr. Sanghamitra Bandopadhyay's example was quoted. Yes, of course, we are proud to have her and many others here on French side also. So this kind of increasement or this kind of enhancement is needed at the decision-making level and allow better understanding for the gender dimensions in research for definition and evaluation of scientific excellence, raise the gender equality and awareness, which has been talked about yesterday. We need to do some kind of dissemination, creation, and success stories of the women scientists need to be published, need to be highlighted. So the policymaker also realize that this is very, very important, and they have been doing excellent science. Build institutional capacity and act upon utilization of available human resources irrespective of gender. That was my last slide. So I'm thankful to everybody for coming here and participating this kind of interaction. On behalf of CEFIPRA, I'm really grateful, and I have learned a lot, and in fact, new ideas have come out. I would request all the four coordinators to come out with some kind of recommendations which can be made available on our website, and also can be shared with the government of both sides, India and France, which will definitely will be a game changer. And this is the second seminar of this kind organized by CEFIPRA, and I am really grateful to everybody. Thank you very much.